Sometimes electronics projects have some relatively complex circuit repeated many times. Here I need 20 drivers for Nixie bar graph displays, and it would be a very tedious task to lay out them all. I much rather would like to lay it out once and create many copies. Unfortunately, in KiCad you cannot copy the circuit together with its corresponding layout and keep them at least in sync. Here I have a bus comprised of 20 PWM signals that drive the bar graphs. The drivers will be in the sheet called bar graphs. First thing, I created a template or a macro of the circuit that I want to replicate. Here it is. It uses standard op-amps that come by 2 per package, so I designed 2 drivers at once. The nets that I want to have nice names in the result are named using expressions enclosed in percent signs. This is to let the script choose the exact net names that I want. I did the same for end pins for convenience. The other part numbers are not important. The expressions have one input variable, uppercase X. Their result will be evaluated and used as net names or reference designator of the clone parts and nets. The two op-amps have the same RevDes but different unit number. This is number 2 and this is number 1. They are the parts of one chip. It is rather important to fill the footprint field of every component in the macro circuit, because otherwise we would have to assign the footprints for every cloned part. Now we copy the macro circuit in place of the original sheet. We can verify that they are now linked by opening the main project and going into the subsheet from the main page. Everything is in place. Now let's take a look at the layout of the macro that I also have prepared. You can see that it's a pretty compact circuit. It uses all the reference designators from the macro. It is now time to launch the schematic cloner. This is where I have the script installed, and here I have help. So we specify the template schematic, the output schematic, which I call cloned, the number of clones, and the size of each clone. We have a result ready, so we can open it and check what happened. Here they are. Take a look at the net names that were specified by macros. They are now substituted and named properly, and their names are matching those of the main sheet. Just a small recount. 4, 5, 6, 7, 9, 10. Perfect. Every part is in its place. Let's save it as a original sheet. Yes, we have one to replace it. And now when we open the project and go to the bar graph subsheet, we can see that our clone results are all there together with the macro. Let's run annotation, it will fix some problems and generate the netlist. Save, exit. And now we open the original board of the project. It already has some parts laid out, some components are in place, even some tracks are there. But I want to add the layouts for my little driver. So first thing, I append the macro that I have created as a new PCB, as a part of this PCB. Here it is. And we move it to some convenient location. Let's check that everything is okay. And you can see here that The reference designators in this layout are also those of the macro circuit from the schematic. Let's try to read the netlist that we have created of the complete circuit. It's called FAPOBARnet. Some parts were not found, but I do not really care. I only care now about the parts that are part of this macro, and I hope that they are all in place, because I have checked that their reference designators and their packages are all specified. All the new parts were loaded here in this top left corner, but we don't care about this. What we have to do now is to create a zone in the comments layer. This zone will tell the other part of the script which part it should use for cloning reference. It gives the size of each clone, and it also tells it which tracks to copy, because the tracks in PCB do not belong to nets as such. We now save this board as a new copy. We call it cloned net because it linked with the netlist. That's how I call it. And now it's time to launch the second script, which is called cloner board, and it has three parameters. The template schematic, because it needs the reference parts, the board, and the output board. With good luck, we have a result. Let's take a look. Here they are, 10 new clones of my bar graph drivers. But so far they are not really linked with the rest of the circuit. They're proper, but we need to do one more thing. We now copy this cloned board in place of the original board, because we are sure that it is fine, and go back to the complete schematic. Now, just for my own pleasure, I would like to put all the clones in a better arrangement. So I make a bigger page and arrange them in a landscape, and I will move them here and there. And now it is actually time when I can delete the original macro, because it already did a job. I have a copy of it somewhere, and here it is no longer necessary. So I can safely delete it. Let's now create the link to the main list. Let's put a hierarchical pin label and call it so that its name matches that of the minesheet and of the net names that are inputs here. And they are BPWM 0 through 19. I put it here, it doesn't matter really. Let's go to the root. Just check it that the names are matching. And now we generate the new netlist with everything in place. Now let's go to the board back to the board, and read this netlist. And this is a triumph. We can see that each little copy is linked to its very own pin on the microcontroller, and it means that we have all the parts of the boards in sync with the netlist, with the schematic, and we can make changes and continue working with this circuit as we see fit. Or we can even repeat this procedure later. Thank you for watching. Bye!